What up everybody, it's your boy TK and welcome to yet another YouTube video. And trust me when I tell you that today I got a truly special one planned out for you, but more about that after the intro. Special one is the one that you all been asking and waiting for so long. Yeah, it's happening. I'm gonna show you how I edit all of my Instagram photos. So without further ado, let's hop into the Lightroom. As you guys can see, we're here in Adobe Lightroom, and in case you were wondering which Lightroom do I use the CC 2019, the newest version of Lightroom. And you're also gonna need to have one more program for this edit to work, which is Adobe Photoshop. I use the newest version of that software as well, but more about it when we get to it. First things first, you guys can see that I have already some photos prepared here, and I'm gonna be editing only one. I don't know why I chose so many of them. To be completely honest, I still don't know which one do I wanna go with. In case you don't know how to import the files into Lightroom, you go to the file, import photos and videos, then you get this box. After this box appears, you have the tab on your left side where you can locate the photos you need for editing. All right. Next thing you need to do is go to the develop module, which is the editing part of the Lightroom, for tweaking brightness, contrast, colors, etc. First of all, I'm gonna have to choose one of these photos, and I'm gonna show you how I edited that particular photo, because you've seen all of them on my Instagram profile already. I still don't know which one I wanna go with. I'm just gonna use this one. I guess you've never seen the whole photo, because the idea when we shot it was to crop it so you can see the details in the background, just the road, this bump and me, and also we want to get rid of this shadow. The first thing I want to do is crop the photo, and here in the develop module on the right side of the Lightroom you have this little tab with a lot of little tools. The one we need is crop overlay. You can either click here or just use the R button on your keyboard. Here where it says original, you can just click it and you have a little drop down menu with a lot of different options. You can enter the custom. You can also uncheck this box and do a little freestyle cropping, but we wanna keep that locked for now. So what I'm gonna do is crop it for the Instagram right away, which is 4x5 format. This is still a bit too big, so I'm gonna just drag it till I find something that suits my need. All right, that seems fine. Then you press enter and that's basically it. Next thing I wanna do is apply the preset that I wanna use as a starting point to my editing. The preset pack I use on all of my Instagram photos currently is this TK preset pack gold, which is now also available on my website, which I launched today. I wanted for you to be able to get these presets as soon as I launched this video, because you wouldn't be able to finish the edit. So yeah, you can go and hop on thatkris.com. You can choose the presets that you like. I have a couple of options. I also offer one free preset pack. In case you're new to the concept, I have fully explained in depth, step by step, how to import and install and use presets on FAQs page of my website. As I said, thatkris.com. Download your free preset pack and import them into Lightroom so you can join the process. And in case you want to use the same preset that I'm gonna be using in this editing tutorial, you can find them on my website as well. But for now, let's just jump back to the Lightroom. All right, once you have the photo ready, you cropped it the way you want it, and you imported your presets into the Lightroom, you can find them here on the left side of your Lightroom in this tab, which is called presets. Now all you need to do is just search for the name of the preset pack that you imported into Lightroom, and as I said, today I'm gonna be using the preset pack that I use on all my Instagram photos, TK preset pack gold. One really good thing that I like about Lightroom is that you can display your presets without even applying them. You just go through each of those without even clicking on them. You just go over the single preset with your mouse and it will display how it looks before even applying it. What I usually use for my Instagram photos is this preset. This is the one that I use in like 75% of my photos. And I believe it looks good already. So I'm gonna use this one here as well. All right, as you apply the preset, you can see that all the information in the right tab change, because that's mainly what preset is. As soon as you're finished editing the photo, in case you wanna save the settings and use them on other photos as well, so you don't have to do it all over again, then you just simply make a preset out of it. And how do I do that? It's quite simple actually. So we go here back on the left side of the Lightroom, and you have this little plus button which says add new presets. You just go to create preset, then you can make a new group, which is actually a folder, which is quite useful for arranging your presets. And then you just give your presets a name, and also you have some settings here in case you want to choose which settings you want your presets to have. And then you just click create, and that's it. Alright, to editing part. I don't want you to get confused about what presets are. Presets are just a starting point, so you don't have to edit your photos all over again every single time you import them into Lightroom. And also, in case you want to match your photos easier, to gain that Instagram feed or for whatever you're using them. But they are only a starting point, which means you will still have to do some adjustments to get that final look. First thing we have here is white balance. This is actually the thing I used to gradually change the look of my photos on my Instagram feed. And in case you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm gonna put my Instagram feed here up on the screen. And as you can see, as I scroll, my Instagram theme changed a bit. When I started out using these presets, it was almost fully golden bronze look, but as we go more up to date, I gradually switched it to look more gold orange tealish type of style. This is still the same preset, and as I said, I use the white balance mostly, with also some other tweaking which I'm gonna show you. So the first thing I would do is double click this dot thingy on the temperature slide, so I get that original white balance look. And the next thing I do is just push that temperature up till I find something that suits my needs. I believe. Not sure. I believe this is fine, around 8500. The next thing would be the exposure. The small problem is this shot was overexposed a bit because it was the direct sunlight, and here in the histogram tab you can see that we used a really wide aperture. So yeah, but I still think I can fix that up a bit later on with the brush. So the first thing, let's just see. All right, that wouldn't change anything here. I would drop down shadows quite a bit. Perhaps, now I'm gonna leave the blacks as it is. You can just go here in the edit and use the undo option, or just use the control plus Z on your keyboard to revert to the last thing that you did. All right, highlights. Okay, I can drop that down a bit and then just push the exposure for one. Yeah, to plus 0.10, that looks good. The clarity seems really nice at this point. I'm not gonna touch that. Next thing, I believe this is a bit too, I believe there is a bit too much blues in the shadows, so I'm gonna gain back that by using the split toning. As you can see, these are the settings that I use on these presets normally, but since our shadows are so blue, I'm gonna go and push it a bit more towards teal. Yeah, that's a nice slight change. Perhaps even in the shadows, not in the, rather than the highlights. Let's see how this looks. This is perhaps even better. Yep, I like this. Okay, the next thing, I'm gonna go back to my HSL color tab. You have some options here in case you wanna adjust only hue or saturation or luminance. For some people, this is much easier way to go through all of these options, but I like to keep them all open. So I have the overlook of everything in case I wanna do some fast readjustments. Only thing I would do here is probably my skin is a bit too yellowish. So yeah, I'm gonna push those oranges a bit more to the red side. All right, that looks fine. Yeah, that looks really nice. And I'm actually quite happy how this looks. I don't think I would do anything else to this shot. As you can see, when using presets, it doesn't really take a lot of time to do some small adjustments and gain that final look. Of course, in case you have some experience already and you know what kind of look you want to gain. But I'm gonna still do one more small thing, and I'm gonna use the adjustment brush for this because I want to affect only the certain area of the image without affecting it all. So I'm gonna have to use either adjustment brush, radial filter, or gradual filter. In this case, adjustment brush, because I want it to be much more precise than these two can offer. So the first thing I'm gonna do is reset this option. You can always just double click the dot thing on the slide and it will reset automatically. Or either you can press the Alt button on your keyboard, and here where it says effect, it will just say reset, then you click on that and it will reset all the settings within the tab. In this particular case, I want to do some adjustments on me and perhaps even on this bump. So for it to be a bit more precise, you can just hold the left click on your mouse together with the control on your keyboard and you just brush away over the subject that you want to mask. I'm gonna fast forward this a bit. Now that you're finished with brushing, in case you're not sure what did you mask, you can go over the dot which represents the certain mask that you were using, and you can see the selected area. In the case you missed somewhere or selected a bit too much, there is really no need to worry. You can always fix that later on. Let's say you can press your Alt key or just go to erase here and unselect the area that you selected by the mistake. Also, if you want to have a better view, you can just drop down the exposure or something, and this lets you see everything that you masked. Alright, it's much easier to fix it this way. This way you can see the whole thing, everything that you want to have. Just do some quick readjustments. Alright, this looks pretty damn good. Now you just reset this and let's see what we want to do. I'm gonna expose it up a bit just so we have a bit more information. Then I'm gonna drop some shadows to gain that contrast to look without gaining a lot of punch from using the actual contrast. Yeah, this seems pretty nice. I'm gonna drop the blacks a bit. Yeah, I think I like this. Yeah, feels really good to gain that extra punch from the background. I use this method in 99% of the cases just to gain that extra punch and to distance myself from the background even a bit more. And I'm gonna add a bit more clarity into this. Yeah, this is actually so nice. You can see the difference. It's nothing special, but it's the small detail that makes it a really nice, really punchy. Love it. Alright, next step, you just press the done button over here and I'm done with the Lightroom. This is how it looks before and after. And I'm really happy with the results so far, but we still have some more readjustments to do in Photoshop. So what you need to do is go to File, Export Your Photo, locate the folder that you want to export this photo to, or in case you just want to go to desktop, you can uncheck this box. I also always put in this custom name so I can arrange it easier later on. I'm just gonna give it some random name, doesn't matter. And then you scroll down, go to this tab, post processing, and here after export you check open in Adobe Photoshop. Alright, so the photo once it's exported is gonna be automatically imported into Photoshop. And now I'm gonna show you the process of how I gained that final look, which a lot of you appreciate on my Instagram. It's not a long process, but it's still a small addition which I like to add to all of my photos, also with some a bit different adjustments depending on the photo, but it's basically the same thing. So the first thing I do is go to this little option here in the corner which says create new fill or adjustment layer. Now when you click it, you can see a lot of different options here. We need this one which is called gradient map. Okay, this looks really fucked up, but yeah, I'm gonna fix it up right now. So you can click here to edit the gradient. I usually just put this black and white and you'll see why. click OK. Now we go to blending modes, but first make sure that your gradient map is checked, not the background or any other layer, but the gradient map, and you click overlay. Now I turn down the opacity to like, I don't know, depends on the photo. I'm gonna go with 20 on this one. In case you're wondering what this does, it actually boosts up the clarity a bit, but it doesn't kill off the colors in the same way the clarity usually does in Lightroom. So I really like to use this option. I like it much more than the clarity itself. And the next thing I would do, check this gradient map, I would multiply it. So you can drag it over here onto this little box. And what this does, makes a copy out of it. I'm not gonna keep the same options. I'm gonna change the blending mode back to normal. I'm gonna change the opacity, perhaps to 23. This seems nice. Okay, and the next thing you need to do for this method to work is check this white box, which represents the layer mask. Then you go to this tab on the left side of the Photoshop and use this brush tool. In case it's showing something else, you can just left click and drag. So it brings out this drop down menu. You need to select the brush tool. You see, I already selected it. So by holding the Alt on your keyboard and the right click on your mouse and dragging it, you can manipulate the size of your brush. So what I need you to do next is go to this little thing and push down the hardness to 0, and also find the size of the brush that's suitable for your need. This is gonna be fine. And now you need to have black and white here selected. And what I want to do is unselect this gradient from me and this bump, so I gain those colors back over here. So how do we do that? First, you need to click the X on your keyboard. As you can see, these two switch and the black needs to be on top. Now, when you have the suitable size of the brush, you just brush away. As you can see, this removes the gradient, which is clearly visible over here. Now just brush over the part of the photo that you want to unselect. Excuse me. You don't have to be too precise, but it's your choice. I'm gonna do this very quickly just to show you how I do it. I'm usually more precise and invest more time into doing this when I edit my photos, but for the sake of the tutorial, I don't want to make this too long. Right now you can see the change. You can see the change of the single, what it has done. You can see how the road is now more desaturated, and this is what I actually like. Now we have two more steps to finishing this, actually three, but the last one is very short. The next step is going back to this little bad boy and opening color balance. What color balance does is let you manipulate the colors in the certain tones in the image, which is either shadows, midtones, or highlights. What I like to do is go to the shadows first. I like to add some cyan to the shadows, so I go -1. Yeah, that seems nice. Yes, nice little change. Then I would go to the midtones next, and I want to balance it out with adding some reds into the midtones. To explain really quick what midtones are, so if this is the highlighted area and this is the shadowed area, this would be the midtones. So yeah, I added some reds to balance it out, and also go to highlights. Usually what I do is also add some blue and cyan into highlights. But in this particular image, I think I'm gonna do something else. Because highlights are really punchy since it was shot in the direct sunlight, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna test it out a bit. I'm gonna add some cyan, but I'm gonna add some yellowish as well to balance it out. Let's see what this did. Yeah, it actually gives it that nice little detail. All right. And the last thing regarding the color grading, you need to add the selective color. Now what I want to do is turn my golden yellows into this particular shade of golden orange, which you can only gain if you do this edit step by step as we already did. So what I'm gonna do is use the red step first. As you can see, we have some colors over here that you can choose. We are gonna only manipulate yellows and reds. I'm gonna give it a bit of cyan, just a tiny bit, +3 seems okay. Then I'm gonna push it a bit more towards the magenta. I believe 18 seems nice, and also add some yellows to balance it out. +8 looks good. Alright, let's see. I'm gonna zoom it in a bit just so I can see what's happening to the skin tones. In case you don't know how to zoom in and zoom out in Photoshop, it's actually quite simple. You just hold the Alt button on your keyboard as you scroll up and down on your mouse. Yeah, it's a really nice little shortcut that saves you a lot of time sometimes. Alright, the last thing I wanna do in the selected colors is go to yellows. Pretty much do the same thing, but still a bit different. Alright, +13 looks good, and put some yellows back. Let's see how this looks. Oh yeah, this is amazing. This looks perfect. Really love how this turned out, and only one last thing that I wanna do is make a copy of my background, and then select the background copy, go to filter, sharpen, and unsharp max, just to sharpen out the whole image a bit. I'm gonna do it about 150, seems really nice. Yeah, this looks amazing. I'm gonna put it up over the screen so you can see the before and the after of the photo. And yeah guys, that's basically how I edit all of my photos. Hopefully this helped you out. Now you can do the same kind of feed in case you want to, or just learn some new techniques that you can use on any other edit, which are quite useful. I use them almost every single time, especially the ones in Photoshop. All of this made my workflow much better. I do it all much faster and it all looks so much better. And yeah guys, I guess that's gonna be it for today. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I'm gonna be doing much more of this in the future. I really enjoyed doing this one. This is probably my favorite video that I shot to this day, because I love color grading, I love doing edits. This is one of my hugest passion, and sharing it with you just makes it so much more fulfilling. And yeah, don't forget, you can get your presets now on Thatkris.com, which I launched today. You also have a free preset pack which you can grab to test it out, see how it all works. You can also grab some of the presets I have also in display over there. I'm gonna be dropping more of them soon. I'm working on the LUTs as well. In case you do the videography and you need to color grade your videos, I'm gonna be doing that as well. I'm gonna be doing tutorials about it too. And yeah, in case you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, comment down below what you thought of this video, what you would like to see in the future. Subscribe, and you know what? I'll see you in the next one.